Hello, everybody! This is Punk Demonio, and welcome back to the Super Mario Galaxy playthrough. Last time, we returned to the engine room in our quest for the Purple Comet by taking on the Purple Coin challenges in Gold Leaf Galaxy and Sea Slide Galaxy. But also, at least what was originally intended to be in that last episode, was also the Purple Coin Challenge for Toy Time Galaxy. However, if you saw my little message at the end of that episode, I ended up cutting Toy Time and ultimately not doing it because it was proving to be very frustrating. The Purple Coin Challenge for Toy Time Galaxy is Luigi's Purple Coins, and basically it takes place on the backside of the giant 8-bit Mario in Toy Time, so you're on a giant 8-bit Luigi, and it is one of the most difficult, if not the most difficult star to go after in the game. But of course, since this is a 100% playthrough, I had to attempt it and beat it, and ultimately I actually did get it done, so let's go ahead and actually get into the gameplay here. Alright, so here we are with the actual gameplay for this episode, and yes, there you see it right there, ladies and gentlemen. It is time for the Purple Comet of the Toy Time Galaxy. And of course, this is going to be a post-commentary for this particular episode. That was a conscious decision on my part because I wasn't quite sure how many attempts it was really going to take me to beat this challenge. And I just decided I'll just record it and then I'll do the commentary later, because if I tried to do it live, there was probably going to be a healthy amount of raging, and you know how that goes. So yes, it is time for the third and final Purple Comet challenge of the engine room, Luigi's Purple Coins. And again, like I said earlier, if this isn't the hardest star in the game, it's definitely a strong contender. Like the Gold Leaf Galaxy, you are on a timer, but this challenge is far more, I guess strenuous is the word, than Gold Leaf. Mostly because not only are you on a timer, you're also in a very, very unsafe environment here, because the giant 8-bit Luigi is composed of the platforms that shrink until they disappear. You also have the flipping platforms. Once you step on those platforms, they will continue to flip. They will not stop, so you need to be very careful with your footing. And other parts of Luigi here are composed of dark matter, which is an instant death if you come into contact with it. So there's a lot to keep track of here. Really, the only saving grace for this particular challenge is the fact that there are more than 100 coins, and you don't have to grab all of them. You just have to grab the requisite 100. So you do have some choices of where you can go, and there are some areas that you could potentially avoid entirely so that you don't have to go through so much bullshit. And as you can see right now, I am actually doing very well on this first run, but if you're looking at the time length of the video here, you can probably guess how this run ultimately turned out. But you can see I'm actually doing quite well for the most part here. I mean, I'm actually getting the coins at a fairly efficient pace. Taking care, of course, like again, you have the disappearing floors, so you wanna take care to make sure that you don't use up all your space. And right there, I actually thought I had died by falling into the dark matter, but somehow I had gotten out and got back onto the tilting platform, but I ended up falling to my death anyway. What had happened was, right there, I saw Mario going into the dark matter, so I closed my eyes like, I don't want to see this death, and then I saw myself falling, and I was like, what happened? It turns out I had somehow saved myself, but I didn't realize it until it was far too late. And right here a couple times, you'll see me fall into the dark matter anyway. I did end up editing out quite a few failures, but I was actually pleasantly surprised at how little time it actually took me. I really only recorded about 10 minutes of footage, so I didn't have to really cut out any massive amounts of failures, but they were definitely there, mostly courtesy of the dark matter. That dark matter is no joke. But I think right about here, we get to the successful attempt. So let's see if I can get this done. Again, 3 minutes on the clock, but again, the timer is not your biggest enemy here. It's definitely the environment because, I mean, again, the dissolving floor, tilting platforms, the dark matter. It's like not only are you're gonna have to be constantly moving, but also you don't want to be reckless either because, again, if you use up all the disappearing, you know, areas, you may find yourself in a situation where you'll have nothing to stand on, and the only thing you can do is fall to your death and take the failure. So, this is definitely, again, a strong contender for hardest star in the game. But again, I was pleasantly surprised at how little time it actually took me to do it once I sat down to do it. I think the reason I didn't get it done in the last episode was because by the time I got to the Toy Time Galaxy in the last episode, I had already been recording for almost 30 minutes, and you know, that had kinda, I'd gotten a little tired, you know, from doing the commentary and stuff, so I think I just needed to take a break, come back fresh, you know, and I would be better able to do this star. And I think also just doing it and doing the commentary later was also beneficial. That meant I was able to focus entirely on the gameplay itself without having to worry about what I was gonna say in the commentary. That's why sometimes most of my Let's Plays are live, but there are moments, there are certain parts of games where I will just record the footage and then do the commentary later, and, you know, it's areas like this that usually call for something like that. But as you can see, I am about to have a successful run. There's the star right over there at the start. So again, don't use up all the disappearing floors, especially back at the start, because again, you could potentially screw yourself out of getting the star. But there's our prize, ladies and gentlemen, and let me tell you, it felt so good to get this star and beat this challenge. Like, when it says Galaxy Complete, I was actually doing the... If we have any wrestling fans familiar with Daniel Bryan back in the day, he would have the yes chant, and he would point up and down by while chanting yes. I was actually doing that when I saw this results screen in the Galaxy Complete message. I was like, yes! I beat that challenge. So, that was a level. That was a Purple Comet challenge, the last Purple Coin challenge of the Engine Room, which means, ladies and gentlemen, there's only one dome left to return to, only 3 Purple Coin challenges left to conquer. And there you see me spazzing out with the Wii pointer, going crazy because I beat it. But, ladies and gentlemen, of course, like I just said, we are not done with the Purple Coins. There's still 3 challenges left in the garden, but I'll worry about those later. Because, ladies and gents, that is going to do it for this episode of the Super Mario Galaxy playthrough. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to leave a like and leave a comment and tell me what you think. And this is Punk Demon Neo signing out for now. I hope to see all of you in the next episode.